My name is Alan Tagatelli, and I'm a professor here at the Salk Institute. In the last 30 or 40 years, the science of medicine has moved from physiology to cells, now down to the molecular level. And when you talk about molecules that are involved in biology and disease, you know, you talk about genes, proteins, RNAs. But there's actually other classes of molecules that are just as important but might not be as studied. In particular, metabolites. These are things like amino acids and sugars and lipids, and also some small peptides which play roles in hormones like insulin and things like that. And so these molecules have typically been more difficult to study. There never has really been very good general methods for looking at all metabolites or peptides within cells. And so as a result, what we've done is really adapted those tools to our needs and to be able to detect these small molecules out of biological settings. And in doing so, have really opened up new areas of investigation and allowed us to do things like discover new molecules that people haven't even known about before. In the future, what we'd like to do is take some of the discoveries we've made in the areas of diabetes, cancer, autoimmune disease, and really push to see if we can actually take the next step towards realizing the therapeutic potential of these discoveries. My background was primarily in chemistry. I synthesized molecules and made molecules, but I really didn't know what they did in a biological setting. But while I was a grad student, I really learned that, you know, certain molecules could control how much pain you felt or how much you slept or didn't sleep. And that really fascinated me, that this idea that there could be this whole world of molecules out there, many of them which we don't know about yet. I like that exploration aspect of it, that ability to find a new thing. And there's really no other feeling I can explain than when you realize that you've learned something for the first time and you're the first person in the world that actually knows it. It's a really exciting feeling, and the idea that you can do that while at the same time hopefully eventually helping people is really gratifying.